How do I fix internal server error? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the beginning of a question. I'm trying to download software from a specific site. No matter what I try to download, I get this error message. Internal server error, etc. I'm not going to read you the whole message. How is this resolved? Well, I'm very familiar with this error, actually too familiar with this error. The problem, though, perhaps the good news, is it's probably not your fault. The bad news is that if that's the case, there's really nothing you can do about it. An internal server error is the server's problem. So if you visit askleo.com and you get an internal server error message, that's a problem caused by my server, by the askleo.com server. It's something that I need to fix. The problem, of course, is that you as a user, you're probably just doing normal things, clicking on links and so forth. So it's almost impossible to understand exactly what might be going wrong. I have options, right? I'm running the server. I have logs to look at. I have things to do with. And ultimately, it is my responsibility to deal with internal server error. But there are scenarios where some things might cause internal server error that might be caused by something you've done, but it's still the responsibility of the server owner to handle that properly. Here's the scenario. You've got a link in email that you are about to click on. You'll notice that maybe the link is long and spans two lines. When you click on the beginning of the link, the second line isn't included for some reason. This happens actually relatively commonly, depending on the email format and your email transport and a whole bunch of other things, right? But the bottom line here is that when you click on the link, you're not really clicking on the whole link. That can very much confuse the server because there may be information that it needed to process whatever it is you're asking for in the second half of that link that you didn't provide. So that could be a cause for internal server error. Yes, it is technically something you did. You clicked on that link. But the issue here is that honestly, the server should do a better job of handling it. Internal server error is like the last resort. It's basically the equivalent, the web equivalent of a blue screen. The server just doesn't know what the heck to do, and all it can do is report the error. So servers should, in theory, never ever show you an internal server error, but of course it does happen. Now, there are some things to grasp at, some straws to grasp at, and those include things like clearing the browser cache, clearing cookies, refreshing the page with F5, or even trying a completely different browser. Sometimes there are things, and I'll just call them things because there's a bunch of different issues that could come up, that might cause your request to the server to be broken in some way or configured in some unexpected way. These kinds of things can potentially reset some of that confusion and hopefully get the next request through. Now, if you're the webmaster, if you're the person responsible for the website that is throwing internal server errors, you got some work to do. You need to go look at your logs. I can't tell you where your logs are because there are, of course, different web servers, but you need to start investigating exactly why it's happening, what's happening, and then do what you can to correct whatever error is happening under the hood. Now, there's one interesting little tidbit here, and that is the error message, the full error message that I didn't read at the beginning, also includes the phrase, additionally, a 500 internal server error was encountered while trying to use an error document to handle the request. In other words, you got an internal server error caused by your internal server error. That second error is really nothing more than the fact that there is supposed to be a web page, an HTML file or some kind of web page specifically designed to report internal server error in a clean and user-friendly way. You've probably seen this with 404, file not found. Many services will present you an entertaining 404 page, or it will at least look like the page or the website that you're looking at. That's because they've provided this HTML file or some kind of a file that is displayed when a 404 happens. For this, the internal server error, error number 500, there is no such page. That's an error, which implies we're going to throw an internal server error for reasons unknown, and then we're going to try and display a web page that makes it look pretty. That web page doesn't exist. Whoops, that's another internal server error. So, hopefully that helps you at least understand why these things happen and honestly, how little you can do about them. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/2649. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.